Alrighty, we can begin. Hello, on behalf of KUKA Robotics, we'd like to thank everyone for joining today's webinar, KUKA PLC MX Automation. Today's session will be presented by Ron Bergerman, Key Technology Manager for Machine Tool Automation. Ron brings a wealth of knowledge and experience to KUKA. He's been in the field of robotics and automation for a while now, 20 plus years. So this webinar will be live in about 2 weeks on our website, as well as our YouTube. Questions about this webinar, you can put them in the questions box in the bar, and I will ask them as we go. Without further ado, we can start today's webinar. So Ron, you can take it away.
Hey, thanks, Austin. Appreciate the intro. It's actually 30 plus years, so I'm officially old. Welcome, everybody. Appreciate your attention and time today. We have a fairly small crowd, so if you have any questions, feel free to ask as we go. Oh, sorry, Austin. Was I muted at the beginning? Okay. Sorry about that, guys. Again, welcome to today's webinar. We have a fairly small crowd, so if you have any questions as we go, feel free to post them, and Austin will forward the questions to me. And we can also do a follow-up Q&A at the end of the session. So as Austin mentioned, today's topic is KUKA PLC MX Automation. And that option is, how to control and program your robot from a remote system. If you are a KUKA robot programmer, then you probably won't be an MX Automation user. If you are a robot programmer and you want to learn how to program a KUKA robot, again, then you probably won't be an MX Automation user. However, if you are a PLC programmer and you have never programmed a KUKA robot, then you might be an MX Automation user. Also, if you have experience with Siemens or Heidenheim NC controls and have never programmed a KUKA robot, you also might be an MX Automation user. So why MX Automation? Why is it useful? Why would you want it? It gives you the ability to use your existing PLC and NC controls experience. So you have experience programming either system, you could use that. Since there's no additional training required for the product, you have very low overhead. You can simplify your operator interface. Whatever system you're using today for your controls, for your HMI, you can reuse and just add extensions for the robot. You can simplify your controls layout. Whatever controls you're using for your machinery, your peripheral devices, or your machine tools, you can use the same to control the robot. And one of the big things today is, as we all know, or most of us know, there's a shortage of robot programmers. And typically, it's easier to find PLC or NC programmers. So this option gives the PLC and NC programmers the ability to program the robot without knowing the robot system. So the whole idea with MX Automation, it allows you to program, do diagnostics, pretty much everything you would do on the KUKA pendant or in the KUKA system, but do it remote from a PLC or NC interface and also with your HMI system. So the end user really doesn't need to know anything about the robot specifically. You can tailor your HMI to your same screens you normally use. Simple robot commands over the PLC NC interface. It's a function library. Or if you're using a high-level language like C Sharp, C++, or Python code, you can also use those. The path planning still remains inside the robot control, but all the commands will come over the MX Automation interface. Jogging the robot or teaching points or paths can be done via the PLC or NC controls. No need to use the KUKA pendant. If you are jogging with a remote device, you typically require our safe operation or safe velocity monitoring to safely control the speed of the robot when you're in manual mode. That's to comply with all the safety standards. So the concept is, we deliver PLC libraries that you can program the robot again from the PLC or the NC control. The libraries are for various PLC brands. One thing to note is the robot's always an automatic external. So the PLC or the NC control has full control of the robot. And our PLC library is just for the functions to and from MX Automation and completely independent of the robot type. We typically control the robot via field bus protocols. And the way it works is we have a system, an MX Automation interpreter that sits in the robot control. It's basically waiting for commands to service the PLC or the NC. And it can buffer those commands as needed, send status back to and from the system. Again, like I mentioned, the path planning and also the safety is still handled within the KUKA control. Since you have the ability to use a remote system to jog or a remote control panel, some customers actually prefer to disconnect the KUKA smart pad or our control panel and put it in a drawer and maybe only take it out for maintenance purposes. And then they would use their custom pendant or custom interface for the robot. So some of the basic functions we have through MX Automation, as I mentioned, jogging, teaching through a non-KUKA pendant as possible. You still have the option to use a KUKA pendant. Standard motion types are all supported. Linear moves, joint moves, circular moves, approximation or blending the motion types, standard triggers, any kind of logic that you would have in a regular robot program, it's also available through the MX Automation interface. And each PLC can control up to 5 robots. Changing bases and tool coordinates, like you do on the robot, is also possible. Having access to the robot I/O system is possible, so you can read and write digital I/O and analog I/O on the robot system. You also have the ability to read and acknowledge error messages. So again, you don't need the KUKA pendant. You can do everything all remote. Some of the advanced functions. So if you're using our safe operation feature, you can execute a brake test through the interface. You can also execute the mastering test from the interface. Some of our tech packages like Conveyor Tech are also available. And again, all the programming is done on the NC PLC side. Nothing is needed on the robot side. Vector move is another option that can be used. It's typically used to compensate the tooling when you're removing parts from a plastic injection machine. Our load data determination, which will automatically allow the robot to move and measure the tool mass, center of gravity of your tool, and mass moments of inertia, can also be executed from the interface. And there's some built-in commands for doing forward inverse kinematic calculations. So we support a wide range of PLC and NC controls. You notice from the list, it's all standard stuff you've seen in the industry. Siemens, Allen Bradley, Heidenheim, for example. And as I mentioned, we also have the ability, if you wanted to do controls from, say, a Linux system or maybe a PC, you could do some programming through C#, C++, or Python. And we support all the standard protocols, PROFINET, EtherCAT, Ethernet IP. Also, there's safety interfaces associated with those. And UDP. One option we've added to MX Automation is a standard robot command interface, as known as SRCI. So this is a new standard that was developed with robot manufacturers and PLC manufacturers. They all came together to create a standard. Within the working group, they developed this standard, mainly driven by Siemens, but it has been adopted by other manufacturers. So to date, the interface itself has approximately 115 robot functions, and I'm sure it will expand over time. The functionality, it's very similar to MX Automation. On our end, it's basically an extension of MX Automation, but to the standard. And very similar where you have function blocks communicating over field bus to create robot motion or program other functions. And the principle is based on a client-server system where the server sits on the robot control and the client, being the PLC, would connect to the server, send commands, get feedback from the server. And again, the communication between the PLC and the robot is typically done over field bus. So now with this new interface, we have the option to use the standard protocols and also the SRCI interface based on the Siemens protocol or the Siemens standard. So as I mentioned, you know, no training is required on the robot side. You could use your existing knowledge of the PLC or the NC controls. So typically on the KUKA robot system, you'd have an inline form, which would allow you to create some motion, for example. And if you're within the PLC, you'd have a function block that basically does the same thing, but you're programming it within the PLC. And another example, if you had C sharp, you'd have function calls to also execute the same type of command. So you don't need to know the KUKA robot language. You're programming it in your native PLC language or your high level language. One good example, we have an interface with Heidenheim CNC controls. So on the top left here, this is a TNC7 NC control from Heidenheim, and it controls the robot directly. On the right, it's the same configuration, but with our larger format robot. So the same interface from Heidenheim can be used to control small robots or large robots. So it really supports the whole product portfolio. And from a high level, Heidenheim has a package that they've developed, and they communicate via Python over to our MX Automation. So the interpreter receives commands from the Python interface on the Heidenheim control. It's quite a powerful package. On the left side, this shows some automation that was added to a machine tool. So in this case, they use an MX Automation to control the robot from the Heidenheim NC control, but also control the NC itself. So one system, one HMI is used to not only program the robot and the NC, but also to control everything from a single HMI. So if you looked at the front end, you would actually see the NC code that'd be running the NC machine. And within that, you'd have robot code that would be in the standard M&G format per the Heidenheim control format that would control the robot. So again, if you're experienced on the NC controls, you don't really need to know anything on the robot. You program the robot from that standard interface. We have something similar from the Siemens side. So you can program either from a Siemens PLC or an NC control to control the robot through the same MX Automation interface. One thing that's a little bit unique with Siemens, they have two channels on their NC control. So one channel could be dedicated for a CNC machine, and the second channel could be dedicated for the robot. So again, single HMI, single high-level control using MG codes to control the robot. One of our big customers, they have an OEM package that they've standardized on MX Automation as an example. So every single system that they ship includes MX Automation. They have their PLC code, they have their own HMI, their own pendant, and it's really a CAN system, and it's a very slick system. Again, everything resides on their side, and MX Automation is used to service their PLC, their NC control. And that's pretty much it for the product. I really appreciate everybody's attention, and we'll open up the floor for any questions you have. My contact information is also shown, so if you have any follow-up questions, feel free to contact me. Email is always the best. Again, thank you for your attention.
There was one question here in the box. It says, is MX Automation a KOP or hardware upgrade inside the robot controller?
It's basically a KOP, so it is an option package, and it's software only. And the only hardware that would be required, you know, the hardware would be in quotes, would be the field bus communication to communicate to the PLC.
Okay. Looks like that's the only question as of now.
Okay, sounds good.
It looks like we got another one that just came in. It says, can PLC also control all external axes?
Yeah, good question. You have full control of the robot and any external axes that are attached to the robot. And that would include external axes that are coordinated with the robot. So robot on a linear slide, a robot controlling a part on a rotary axis. So up to 6 external axes.
Okay. Do you know if there is a compatibility with Omron PLC?
I'm not 100% sure. That's something we'd have to investigate. But if you could forward me that question through email, I'll check on it. I'm not familiar with Omron PLCs directly, but I'm sure we have something.
Alrighty, it looks like those are all the questions. So if that's it, Ron, thank you very much. Just want to let all the attendees know that this will be live. This recording will be live on our website and also on our YouTube in about 2 weeks after today. So be on the lookout for that. I'll also be sending out a follow-up email reminder with the link and then also with where else this will be stored. So if there's any other questions, please contact Ron. If that's it, thank you everyone for joining today's webinar.
Thank you. Thanks, Austin. Appreciate it.
Industrial intelligence.